I'm Richard McCarthy, wedding photographer, and welcome to The Wedding Show, where we offer tips and advice on planning your wedding. We hear from experts in the wedding industry and get their opinions and listen to their experiences in the hope of helping couples plan their special day. To get involved in the conversation, simply leave a comment or questions in the comment section below, or you can private message us at info@myweddingstore.ie, or pop in and see us here in Colony, County Sligo. The show is brought to you in association with MyWeddingStore.ie. My Wedding Store, in case you didn't know, is a one-stop shop for all your wedding needs. And for more information, check out MyWeddingStore.ie, incorporating retail, hire, and wedding services. If you'd like to sponsor an episode, then please get in touch. Or if you'd like to sponsor a prize or a giveaway, then of course, let us know privately and we'll organize that. In this week's episode, we are joined by three fantastic wedding photographers. Steve Rogers of Steve Rogers Photography. How are you, Steve?
Very well, thank you. Very well.
Thank you so much for joining us. And we have Francis Muldoon of Francis Muldoon Photography. How are you, Francis?
I'm very good, thank you. Good evening.
Thank you very much for joining us. And of course, Eleanor Corcoran of Eleanor C Photography. How are you, Eleanor?
I'm great, Richard. How are you? Great to be here.
Thank you all for joining us. And also joining us tonight is Brian McDermott in the trenches on the tech, monitoring the social media and producing the show along with Michael O'Donovan, who's taking a well-deserved break after last week's episode and making the tea tonight. Tonight's show is all about wedding photography. So first of all, I'd like to introduce our guests. So I suppose we'll start with Eleanor. Eleanor, tell us all about Eleanor C Photography.
Hi, everybody. I'm Eleanor, and I'm from Eleanor C Photography. I'm based in Enniscrone. I've been there in business nearly 10 years now. So I concentrate mainly on wedding photography, newborn, and portraits.
Fantastic. That's a wide range.
It's a wide range, yes.
Yeah. Very good. And Francis, tell us all about Francis Muldoon Photography.
Well, my main area would be weddings and portraits. I have a photographic studio in Ross's Point, stunning location, and it has fabulous backdrops as well.
Yeah, it's beautiful landscape on there.
Experience, well over 20 years experience. I love what I do, and we make music magic together.
Fantastic,
and my clients.
And I forgot to ask you, Eleanor, but Francis, where do you cover, like we say, you cover all of Sligo, Zoom, and?
I mainly cover the Northwest.
Very good.
Locally here, all the local hotels, and a lot of my clients are from the local Northwest area, or for people visiting, coming from overseas. We have a lot of people coming to the wilds. Atlantic Way,
the whole lot, yeah, exactly. And Eleanor, Enniscrone is quite a popular spot as well. You cover, and it has a wide reach as well. So, like, you cover, I presume, Sligo and
Sligo and Mayo, yes, exactly. Definitely, Enniscrone is fantastic. I mean, it's two great hotels, and we'd have a lot of brides that get married maybe about an hour away, and then they travel into Enniscrone.
Yeah.
About 80% of my weddings when it finish up in Enniscrone, which is fantastic for me. But yeah, I cover Mayo, Sligo region.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. And we have, of course, the famous Steve Rogers. Steve, tell us all about Steve Rogers Photography.
I'll tell you a bit.
Okay, just a little bit.
I love taking photos too. And taking photographs since I did my leaving cert. Mm-hmm. I got my first camera in 1979 and haven't stopped. And I take photos for fun and take photos for money. And that's kind of... You know, that's, I do all sorts of photography, wedding photography, commercial photography. I'm about 50-50, really, commercial photography and wedding photography.
Fantastic. And again, where would you cover, Steve? I presume you cover most of the Northwest as well.
Yeah, most of the Northwest. It's really Sligo, Mayo, Leitrim, Roscommon. It's best for me. I sometimes do weddings in Galway too. But it's mostly in the Northwest.
Very good. And we're very lucky now because we say these lovely people will spend more time behind the camera than in front of the camera.
Yes,
so I'm very grateful for you to come on board tonight and sit in front of the camera and talk to our guests. So a lot of experience between the whole lot of you. And I would just, hopefully people will know, we say from the previous episodes, I'm a wedding photographer as well. And again, similar, I cover the same areas as you guys will say, the Northwest, and I'm based in Tobacore, so I'm kind of stuck in the middle of you kind of with the whole Northwest kind of covered with everything that we do, so we won't delay anymore. So basically, let's get started with the show. So I suppose what we're really talking tonight about is about wedding photography, and I've asked our guests on board because we wanted to kind of get their opinion and their experience involved in the questioning. So I suppose we start off with something simple in regards to the first steps that couples would do when they are looking to book their photographer. What should couples look for when they're booking a photographer? So, Eleanor, I suppose we start with yourself. What do you think that couples should look for when they are booking a wedding photographer?
I think they should look for a photographer that they know their style, and they know that when they speak to that photographer, they have a great relationship with that photographer. That photographer spends the day with them. We spend Absolutely, and we yeah. see them from the beginning of the morning right through until the end of the evening, that they get on with them, but that they also know what to expect from the photographer, that to see their albums, to meet them, to discuss it with them, and whatever expectations they have, that they go through it and speak together. So I think it's very important that they meet them and they like the style the photographer is offering.
Absolutely, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I suppose, Francis, the same question to you in regards to, you know, what should couples start looking for when they are booking their wedding photographer?
They should look for somebody professional mm-hmm. that knows what they're doing, that has experience under their belts, that will work with them every step of the way. They will listen to them. They will understand what type of images will work for them. And they'll help organise the photography for the day. Mm-hmm. Organised and stress-free. Happy days.
Very good, very good. And I suppose, Steve, as well, we'll say you'd be quite familiar with the kind of all the onset of, we'll say, wedding photography. We'll say, what do you think, we'll say, couples should really look for when they are booking their wedding photographer?
I suppose your wedding photographer is not just taking pictures. That's the bit that people see, is that your wedding photographer is taking the pictures. But actually, your wedding photographer is a bit more than that.
Absolutely, yeah.
And your wedding photographer kind of is quietly the MC, organising and responsible for the timing,
yeah,
really, and for trying to set things so that all the different suppliers, it's different, you know, you've got the driver, you've got the celebrant, you've got the musicians, you've got the hotel, and your photographer is kind of the link in between all these people. And so, if you know, I suppose it's a lot to the hidden part of photography is the people management, and the just being able to get your mother to do something without annoying her takes, you know,
skill.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think that's something that, you know, is not kind of widely shown out there, in that there is a lot of photographers out there and everybody has their own style, everybody has their own expertise and all. But I think this person is going to be spending the day with you. Your most, you know, the most important day, one of the most important days of your life.
One
and
off,
you know, you want somebody that you're going to trust. You know, there's a big element of trust there. And as Eleanor was saying, like, you know, it's very important that you meet your photographer, that you know, you spend time with your photographer, and you know, that they get to know you. And that way then, you know, you're going to get the best results, you know, on the day, you know. I suppose one thing that we've noticed in the market ourselves in regards to the weddings and what happens with the images after the weddings and the whole lot is albums, wedding albums and prints and so on, and what people do with their photographs. I suppose in the last, we'll say, 10, 15 years, we've noticed kind of a steady move towards digital. Guys, I meant to ask you this. We say, do you all shoot digital now, or do you use film as well, or film digital?
I shoot digital, but have the experience of shooting
The film, yeah. So you would have...
So it's lovely to come from that background as well.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
And Steve, you would have done film and digital, would you?
I used to have a darkroom in a caravan. I used to do my own black and white printing. Spend an entire night, and you do a print.
Yeah.
And the next day, it looks like shite. So you might as well spend the next night doing another one. And so that was like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So from there now until it's fantastic to be able to take an image, bring it to your computer, edit it, do the business on it, and pop it out through a really high quality printer. It's a buzz to print.
Yeah,
to shoot and print.
It's something that I think that, you know, one of the important factors that we do this show is literally to educate couples and to educate brides and grooms in regards to, like, because obviously most of them, it's their first time getting married. Mm-hmm. They've never been through this process. And I think prints and albums are a very important factor of that. And it's something that I think people need to start looking at. So we'll say, why do you think, we'll say, Francis, prints and albums are still relevant in weddings?
Well, I'm glad you've asked me that question, because I brought along a lovely little parent album.
Yeah.
And it's also ideal for the handbag in the glove compartment, or the glove compartment of the car. It's very easy to bring along.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it tells a story from start to finish, all about that couple, their story of the day. What we supply would be digital images as an option with an album or without an album.
Yeah.
And most of our couples go for a wedding album and or digital images. But we have the option if they want to go without the album as well. I personally love hard copy.
Yeah.
I love the vinyl, I love the hard copy, and it's how an image comes to life on hard copy, whether it's an album or a framed piece, is very differently to how it looks backlit on a screen.
Yeah, exactly.
And it just speaks a different language. Yes. Lovely latitudes.
I think, and we'll say, like, Steve, in your experience, we'll say, you know, you would have seen the, we'll say, the movement from prints and albums to digital and the whole lot. And, you know, I think you work very similar to me in that we do some digital packages, and, you know, the albums and prints are done separately. Yeah. But it's still that important thing that we're trying to get across to couples that, you know, think about what's going to happen after, we say, the you know, after the wedding. What are you going to do with your photographs? Like, yeah. where do you come, we say, in regards to prints and albums? I presume you still do prints and albums yourself anyway as well.
Yeah. Well, prints and albums are, as we were talking earlier on, just offline, about, are we sure that USB keys are going to work in 4 years' time?
Absolutely, yeah.
Because we were all pretty sure that VHS cassettes were going to work in 4 years' time. Yeah. We were all pretty sure that CDs used to work, would work. But I mean, remember CDs, you know? Yeah. So we're pretty sure that USBs are going to work in 10 years' time, say.
Yeah.
So, you know, you got to get it printed. You do have to eventually get it printed. Yeah. The way I do it is I separate. I take the photos, but I suppose, for want of a better word, I would outsource the album. But yeah, I'd love it if everybody got an album done, because that's something solid to hold in your hand.
Absolutely.
Rather than virtual pictures, which is the way they all are on our phones now. And stuff, you know.
I think it's one of the things that's, it's just been a factor of the recession and a factor of
it's a factor of the recession, actually.
You know, and as we say, Eleanor would say, like, how do you find, we say, with prints and albums? Do you find a lot of brides are going for prints and albums? How would you find them?
I think definitely. A good few of the bride and my couples would have an album and like to have an album. Mm. Now, there could be a budget issue where they decide to go for the digital package initially and then with an intention to come back and to finish the album or to get it.
Yeah, that'd be it.
But to be honest, 9 times out of 10, a couple who go for a digital package don't, unless they're printing something themselves. And the problem with that is, it's not that it's a problem, some people like to do it. Once it leaves us, I mean, we have no control over where they get it printed, what company they're using to print it.
That's right.
There's no consistency to it.
Yeah, there's a huge difference,
isn't
there?
There's a huge difference in what we would produce and what you might get it in your local Fuji store. I'm saying there's absolutely nothing wrong with it, but it's not the end product that we actually like to see finished for our clients.
Yeah. A little known fact, actually, a lot of people don't realise that a lot of those kiosks that you see in the chemists or any of those, they have a system where basically when you put in your thing, it'll auto-correct the image before it prints. And it actually ruins the image.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, so I think a lot of people don't realise there's a lot going on in the background in regards to the images. I suppose, touching on what you said, Steve, about the USB, like, your average USB will only last, you know, 3 to 5 years.
Yeah. Is that it? Yeah.
Yeah, that's basically it. Wow. And even DVDs as well, CDs and DVDs, again, the same thing, 3 to 5 years. And
really? I didn't know that.
It's something that, you know, a lot of people leave on the long finger.
Yeah,
it's something I would love to see people going back to prints, going back to albums, because it's for the next generation. It's not just for you know, for them. It's for, like, their grandkids or their kids, you know, to be able to see. And I think I was saying before about that, you know, a lot of people used to say whenever you know, if there was a fire in a house, and the one thing that was grabbed was the family album. You know, it was so important. And I think it's those mementos that, you know, are going to get lost if people don't do something about it, you know?
Put it into physical form.
Put it into physical form, exactly. I suppose when we're talking about, we'll say, preparing for their wedding day and the whole lot, we'll say, what would you recommend couples do to prepare for their wedding day, Eleanor?
In terms of photography or just in general?
In general, kind of, I suppose more towards the photography. We'll say, like, what tasks, like, do you create to help, we'll say, couples prepare for their wedding day or, you know, like I was saying, people, this is their first time getting married, hopefully. Yeah. And, you know, there's a lot that, it's not just a case of a photographer just showing up and going, hi, I'm just going to capture everything. You don't need to worry about things.
It's much more impressive than that.
There's a lot of work goes on in the background that a lot of photographers don't do, or that a lot of photographers do
yeah.
And that you don't see, you know.
Yes. Yeah.
So I suppose we'll say from your own opinion and experience, we'll say what would, like, for example, would there be one thing that you recommend couples to do to prepare for their wedding day? Like, for example, you know, an engagement shoot or, you know, practice their posing or something like that, you know?
Yeah, no, I totally agree with you. And anytime I say to couples, you know, you can do an engagement shoot, and definitely it's usually the men or the grooms that don't want to do it
don't like photos.
Yeah. I always insist on meeting the couple, if at all possible, meet them. Yeah. And that's actually part of my contract. You know, I'd like to meet them to see what they're like. And it gives me a good idea of what. But I always say to them that if they're easygoing, if their bridal party are good fun, then we will get some nice natural pictures. I don't like to take them for hours and hours. The whole idea is that they come back to the hotel and they have the day with their family and friends. That's what Absolutely. They're there for. But after the day is over, they want the pictures of their day. They want the pictures with the family, their friends, their bridal party. So they need to put a little bit of preparation into it.
Yeah.
And they need to know that it takes time, I suppose, to get all that there for them.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
But you're right, we spend the whole day with them and we don't just take pictures, we do the little flowers, which side they go on for the mums and dads. Yeah,
I'm trying to think of the name of those. Is it boutonnieres or corsage? Or there's so many different names for them. And I'm always trying to figure out, and they just say that button thing, that flower thing there. Yeah, yeah.
But, and tie shoes, we do it all. And we do keep them to time on the day. But they just need, I suppose, if you get to meet the couple, then you get to explain all this to them.
Absolutely.
And it kind of puts them at ease that if you're the one that's keeping them to time, well, then we're going to get back to the hotel on time or with a nice bit of time, so they're not rushing straight into the meal. They need, I suppose, realistic to be told what happens on the day.
Yeah.
And once they know that, then I suppose they can relax a little bit more and enjoy it.
Absolutely. Francis, any recommendations for couples preparing for their day?
Oh, well, photographically, important that they speak with their photographer and the photographer listens to them and identifies what's important to them, because every couple is different.
Mm.
What will work for one couple could be completely opposite to another.
Yeah.
And their photography needs to speak of them, who they are, who their families are, where they've come from, and their journey to date, what has brought them together. And it's lovely to listen to all that information and let it go round in your head. Images are coming as they're speaking to you. And then you plant the seed. How would you feel about? How would you feel about? And Bob's your uncle, they're up for it. Planning is very important. As photographers, image makers, we're also artists. So that is, we were creative on the day. But planning the day is so important photographically. Taking pockets of time, not hijacking their day, going off to do a model shoot. And
of all the phones, I forgot to switch off my own phone.
This is live, by the way.
Whoever it is, I'll ring you back, don't worry.
Because I'm going to move your mic. Really nice.
Okay.
That's
super.
Good.
Lovely.
This is Brian behind the scenes here.
Okay. Now I'm hidden.
You can't hide anymore.
Not at all. But it's very important that we listen and we plan. We sit down. We do even a time plan.
Yeah.
And I mentioned earlier, organized, stress free. It's the happiest day of your lives, guys. And you know, it's so important that you enjoy, and you enjoy who you're working with. They're working with you and for
right.
you.
That's right.
And it's not about the photography, it's about you. It's about your day.
Yeah.
And it's our job to record it, whether we're a fly in the wall, director. It's so important to be able to direct certain parts of the day. And then take the special images, those images that count, that touch your heartstrings, that you know, that you sit back and say, "Wow, bring tears to your eye," you know, let us be creative on the day, yeah. but we work with you.
Yeah, planning. Exactly. I think it's something that I remember, Steve, we talked about this at the Diamond Coast Wedding Fair. We were saying about, you know, preparing people for their wedding day, but also to remember like that, you know, they need to be able to, the emotion on the day, you know, they need to be able, like you were saying, I can't remember the exact quote you gave me, but things like we say about that, you know, they need to be able to spend time with each other and just kind of remember why they get married and, even to make them laugh and the whole lot. And you know, it comes out in the photographs,
yeah,
you know,
absolutely. I
think it was like, give them a tickle or something like that. I can't even remember the exact words, but Mick has it off by quote. I think he's written over the thing. So I would say, in your experience, we'll say, Steve, we'll say, what, is there any recommendations you'd suggest to guests or to couples with preparing for the day?
Definitely meet your photographer, like, and go through your timing of the day. It's so worth it because that means that the three people are all going through the timing of the day, and you'd be amazed how often the fellas would say, "Oh, are we doing that?" Or whatever. And it's great. So that means that the three of us know exactly what's happening. What I try to do is I try to do a sort of like a rough spreadsheet of timing. So people, you know, roughly, okay, and you're going to try and get away to the church at 12:45, right? Mm-hmm. It's so worth getting your timing right. Ladies, be ready a little earlier than you think. Please don't be getting ready at 12:30 for a 1 o'clock wedding. Because it's tricky, and the last half hour just vanishes. Mm. It can take 10 to 15 minutes to get from the kitchen into the car. It can take 15 minutes to get to the church, and it can take 15 minutes to get out of the car and into the church.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm.
So, you know, for what sounds like a 5-minute journey, it's actually 45 minutes. Mm. And it's so worth being on time, and you know, anyway, blah, blah, blah.
There's a lot of good advice there, really.
I think, yeah, timing. So, yeah, so I would try to meet up every time beforehand. You know, I like to do a pre-wedding shoot myself because it gets people used to being under fire.
Yeah.
And it's fun. It's always fun because it's only the three of us. I'm not under pressure because I'm not getting paid for the job.
Yeah.
You know, to take those photos, this is just part of the crack.
Yeah.
So I'm not under pressure.
Yeah.
They're not under pressure because they don't have to dress up and they're not in front of 200 people.
Mm. Yeah, exactly.
And then they get used to being photographed by your photographer even for 10 minutes, for 5 minutes.
I think
it's great fun.
Yeah.
And that sets the tone nicely. So then I know the couple. I know if they're, you know, if somebody's wearing glasses, I'll know how the reflection is on the glasses. If somebody blinks like heck or whatever, I kind of know. Some people are great for holding hands and hugs and kisses and stuff like that. And some people just don't really do that.
So,
most people do, of course, now, but you know what I mean. Some people don't. So you kind of get to learn how shy people are in front of you.
Yeah.
Rather than in front of you and 230 odd people.
Exactly.
Half of whom have iPhones at the same time as you're trying to take a shot.
Or iPads, even worse.
Ooh, iPads.
Grannies with their iPads. I think you're absolutely right, and I think it's one of these things that a lot of people. It's probably their first time getting professionally photographed. Mm. You know, apart from their communion or confirmation, but you know, so it's I really do love the kind of engagement shoots because
I enjoy the engagement. It's
like a practice session for the wedding. They get to see, you know, how we get to see how they interact. They get some lovely photographs. They get to realise, hey, you know, we're actually pretty good looking.
Yes, that's right.
You know,
that's right.
I didn't realise we could do that. You
honestly,
know,
I agree.
You know, so it's quite good.
Yeah.
I think we'll say, from my perspective, I suppose, one thing we touched on there was the timeline. That, you know, it is important for people to realise, you know, to know the timings, because it's one thing that delays your wedding and it puts you under stress.
As well as that, it gives your photographer and your videographer a chance to do you justice.
Yeah.
If you're running late to the wire, then it's you can't expect, you know, what do you expect? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If you're leaving everything to the last second and everything's a rush and you're rushing out the door and everything's, you got to give your photographer and videographer a chance, and you do that by being ready ahead of time.
Yeah.
Plenty of time before the ceremony starts, and it makes it so much easier for everybody. And you can do your own selfies, and you can have the crack,
right.
and have a cup of tea, that's it. Yeah.
I think we haven't touched any on social media. Brian, have you anything on social media, or do you want me to?
Is there anybody out there, Brian?
There's loads of people out there, by the looks of it.
Is there?
Let me see. You can hear me now. Yeah, few questions in here, Richard. Sean and Monaghan, would you rather a bride and groom come with a list of pictures they would have liked to have taken, or do you generally go with the flow?
Okay, that's a good question. Guys, we say shoot lists. We say we call them shoot lists. We say in regards to a list of shots that people want, obviously. But is it something that you know that you get a lot of, or do you kind of? I personally find that we say it's an element of trust that people know that you're going to do the photographs, and the shoot list is normally just photographs that will be outside the norm. You know, what do you think, Steve?
Oh, Francis.
Oh, sorry, Francis.
All right, okay. I've no problem in giving... It's actually a question I have. Any special requirements? Mm-hmm. And we go through that with them. Once it's not a shopping list of all the shots, because I want to work with a flow.
Yeah.
I want to keep that flow going. I want to work, be creative with them, mm-hmm. rather than having to check this list. Yeah. And it breaks the flow.
It does.
So absolutely, I do ask them to think, what special photographs would they like? Mm. What visions have they for their day? And that's what I work with. Mm. But certainly, you know, when it comes to the families, I have a whole plan. They take the least possible time and we get them all.
Yeah.
And I take a list of the families and we build up and we build down. Lanigan's ball, stepping in, stepping out, move on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And I suppose like a lot of us probably the shoot lists that we get are fairly standard photographs anyway. They're photographs that we normally would do, that there's not a need for a shoot list. It's mainly kind of more for like the family photographs. That'd be kind of quite a popular one.
If you've got friends that have come over from Mexico for your wedding, they should be photographed and that shouldn't be missed. Really shouldn't be missed. If your buddies have come from Canada, so I think yes, a wedding list is fine, but the trick of it is don't just share that with your photographer. Show that to your bride's chief bridesmaid and say, here now, look, I don't want to miss my godmother. I don't want to miss my friends from Mexico. I don't, you know, these are, and say it to the best man. Say, look, lads, the only thing I want is the football team.
Yeah.
Me and the boys, the football team.
Yeah.
Let's make that happen.
Yeah.
So it's not just the photographer's responsibility. You get your best man involved. Get your chief bridesmaid involved. If there's special pictures to be taken, certainly write the list. Mm. Where lists get scary is where lists, well, we'll have all the cousins on my side, and then we better have all the cousins on mum's side of my side.
Yeah.
Well, if we do my cousins on my mum's side of our side, we better do all the cousins of dad's side.
Yeah.
But we better do the same for the groom too.
Yeah.
Okay, so could we have all the groom? You know, off you go. And you get lost into cousins and that's political. No, don't do that.
And then there's one missing.
There's one cousin missing. And it's a political nightmare.
He's gone to the bathroom or the bedroom.
He's sitting in the car and he couldn't be arsed having his picture taken. Uncle John.
That's the planning. The planning comes in.
Yeah,
exactly. Plan the family photographs. Who's in?
It should be simple and tidy and not too complicated. If Mum would like a picture with her sisters, certainly, by all means. But Mum, you organise that. Get your brothers and sisters to wait after the church. We take the shot like that, no problem.
But
there's no point in just sharing that list with your photographer because you cannot accept that responsibility to get your friends from Mexico.
Yeah. And that's the one thing, actually, a lot of couples, I find that they're sharing the list with us, but they should be sharing the list with the people that they want in the photographs. As in, Tom and Mary, you need to be at this location.
Precisely.
And that's the one thing, I suppose, timing is a big thing as well, in regards to there's certain times of day we can create those shots.
Exactly.
There's certain times we can't. You know, it's just down to, you know, that there's too much going on at certain times of the day to be able to pull everybody and do a photograph when you're losing a half hour because it's taken us half an hour to recreate that shot, you know?
Yeah.
It is great, though, to photograph special people because everybody's got one auntie in particular that really took care of them as a kid.
Yeah.
And I always gave them a birthday present, whether they asked for it or not.
Yeah.
And they should be photographed. Your favourite godmother should be photographed.
Yeah.
If she was sweet to you when you were a kid. Yes.
Yeah,
so yes with the list, but don't give it to me.
Don't give it to
your bridesmaid.
I think that's a good idea to give the list to somebody who can organise that on the day as well.
Yeah.
You know, do you get a lot of lists, Eleanor?
Not really. No.
No.
To be honest, like that, it's more than that on my contract. It is as well. Any special requirements or anything that you'd like that something that I'm not going to know about this couple. We don't know everything about them. So
yeah, that's true.
I would get an awful lot of bride and grooms asking me for their hen and stag group pictures, which are lovely. But great I idea. Do exactly what we've just said. I ask them to ask the bridesmaid to round up all the girls. Yeah. And you know something is lovely? Because the girls love being in them pictures. Yeah. So they're waiting there for you.
They will make the effort.
The boys will be in the bar. They're usually... but one of the boys, send them off to get them and they'll come out. And once once you have everybody there, it really doesn't take long to get them photographed.
And it's good fun. It's good fun. Get photographed with your friends. Don't just get lost. Do make the effort. Get your friends organised. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Get your hen party. Definitely get your stag party.
And obviously, like I was saying, do you find it easier to do all those shots kind of at the reception? Rather than actually outside the church or anything like that.
At the reception, definitely.
I find family at the church, friends at the hotel, is safer.
Yeah,
you have to nail the family, or not the church. You keep saying the church, but the place of the ceremony.
Yes,
you have to get the family quick because you might not have the four and five year olds.
Exactly,
might not be in particularly good humour at 5 o'clock at the hotel, and their parents could be even worse humour. Not implying, of course, you know.
I suppose we'll just go back to social media in regards. I just want to give a shout out to anybody who's watching. We have Michael watching, Michael Donovan. Thank you, Mike. Carrie Fielding joining us, Mark Mooney. Mark Mooney actually mentioned it. It's a thing I mentioned in two episodes ago about he has this, it's called a baravan. So it's like basically a bar that they've converted this caravan into a bar. So it's like a little chimney.
Lovely.
You can take it with you and all this kind of stuff. So he was just putting the link up there to the baravan pub. Julie Kikoli, hi Eleanor and Steve, go team Enniscrone. We have Sarah Healy, Frances, done my wedding album over 10 years ago and I still love looking at it.
There you go. She hasn't aged a bit.
Brian Pearson, Eleanor and Steve are two of the best around. Thanks for including me in that, Brian. Mary Clark, very talented people on the show tonight, love working with them all. David Kennedy, unplugged weddings are the way to go, lads and ladies. That's something actually I think we probably could discuss in regards to this push for unplugged weddings. And for people who are not aware of unplugged weddings, it's more kind of that you normally see the signs you come into the church, you know, to ask the guests basically to hold back on sharing photographs on social media or taking photographs and let the photographers basically do their job, you know. Is this something that we kind of are starting to see, or is this something that's still taking its time to come through? Like, we'll say, one thing I noticed was a lot of weddings last year was as the bride and groom were walking down the aisle, everybody literally peeping out with their phones and the whole lot, and even the iPads sticking out and the whole lot. You know, is this something that we will see kind of unplugged weddings? What do you think, Frances?
Well, I've seen from experience the bride coming up the aisle with her father, beautiful moment, and being stopped by
Some of their friends, family,
with their phones, their iPads. I have no problem people taking photographs once they don't disturb, interrupt, break the flow. There is also a lot of couples are saying, I'm hearing this very loud and clear, that they'd rather people don't post photographs up without them seeing them, because they're not professional photographers. Some of them take pretty good photographs, but they'd like to censor them. They'd like to have a look at them before. So maybe that's something that they should think about there. I've had some brides and grooms asking their family and friends not to take photographs, being the unplugged there. But surprisingly, they went against their wishes and they insisted that they take out the phones. There was one delicate case, actually, where a child wasn't to be photographed, and they asked, and I actually spoke from the pulpit and asked them, you know, not to photograph especially any of the children and put them up on Facebook. But they did, even being asked by the couple, being asked by the priest and the photographer, they still did. So respect, you know, respect the wishes of the bride and the groom.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's it. Yeah. And I think
it's something
that we were talking beforehand just about, was say, you know, images on social media and licensing and stuff like that, that we people need to be careful with, say, what they're putting up on social media. And a lot of couples like that, you, like you mentioned, would say that their friends are putting up the photographs and the bride and groom mightn't like it, you know? So, like, say, do you see a lot of kind of, would say, from the social media side, would say, a lot of people literally putting up photographs, you know, before the bride and groom? And is it something that bride and grooms are kind of very sensitive about?
I couldn't answer that because I don't really look at people's Facebook feeds. Or I don't really, personally speaking, I don't really do that. So I can't honestly answer you.
Well, more in regards to kind of, we'll say, like that, you know, if we'll say, if we're sharing photographs on social media, like we'll say, do you find a lot of couples kind of asking that, you know, photographs aren't put on, or like the wedding photographs aren't put on social media?
You see, the thing about photographs is that there's two sides to it. You've got the physical side of it. Mm-hmm. In other words, is it correctly exposed and sharp and in focus? And you've got a spiritual side to it. Mm-hmm. As in, the precise timing of the expression of both people or of the group or of the one person.
Yeah.
That's the spiritual side of photography, and that's what we're being paid for.
Yeah.
I don't care if that sounds wafty. I really don't. Everybody can get it. You can get the picture in focus and correctly exposed on your iPhone. But will you get that timing, that tiny infinitesimal inth of a second where you're looking really nice, like, and really pleasant and open, and the photo is honest. And that is the tricky bit. So that's very hard to do on an iPhone at a wedding.
Yeah.
We have a better chance of doing it with a big lump of a camera that's got a motor drive on it and goes pop, pop, pop. Yeah. And you're not going to get a blink, for instance.
Yeah.
Exactly. You're only going to go pop, pop, pop when the couple is, you know, are looking well.
Yeah.
But on an iPhone, you'll see people are just going bang, bang. They don't care about the spiritual end of it, about the timing. And it's not it. It's in focus and it's sharp and it's colourful. Bang, bang, bang.
Yeah.
And it's those pictures, when they go up on Facebook, they don't do anyone justice.
No.
Yeah.
And that's why people are, I think, wriggly about Facebook pictures going up. There's enough really awful photographs taken by phones.
Yeah, I think so.
Of really beautiful brides and grooms.
Yeah. I think we'll say, Eleanor, like, would you get a lot of brides kind of requesting photographs to be put? Like, we go the opposite side, we'll say, in regards to, you know, would you get a lot of brides or couples that want their photographs put up on social media, they want them put up straight away and stuff like that?
It's like a preview.
Yeah.
And I'd always say to a couple that I like to put up a few photographs for them, but it's photographs that I choose for them and that they leave up to me, as in what ones I pick for them. Yeah.
Kind of like a sneak peek.
Exactly. Now, there are couples who don't want them up either. I even had a couple of brides who've recently had to put it in their invitations. Mm. Please don't use cameras only. They wanted to wait for. And then they'll wait for the sneak peek and they'll share those ones, which is great because they get to see, as you said, that moment, that setup, that picture that makes them look fantastic.
The timing is key. And you won't get that in an iPhone.
I think that that's something, like, I presume we can speak for all of us, but in regards to, like, when we're putting up the photographs, we're getting permission from the couples. We're getting all that beforehand. So it's not a case of literally that we're firing stuff up just for the sake of stuff on social media. There is a lot that goes into what we do before we put the photographs up, but there's always, we're always sensitive to the couple's, you know, their position on it, you know. So if a couple don't want stuff on social media, absolutely fine. You know, that's something that... You know, we always kind of ask beforehand anyway, you know, so
I kind of do it the other way around. I only put them up if I'm asked to put them up.
Exactly, which is a good way to do it.
It's the way I do it.
Yeah, and I think people have to respect that look, if they're not seeing photographs up every week, you know, that, like, most of us are working, we're working every weekend at a wedding. There's a lot of weddings we don't put up on social media. And we have to respect the privacy of those people,
Unless they're asked.
And I think it's something that we were saying about, we say, regarding licensing and everything as well, that people need to realise that, look, when you do put something up on social media, it's, you know, it's up there for anybody to take, you know. There is a bit of an element of fear there in regards to what people will do with your images. So I always say to people, you know, be cautious in regards to social media.
Absolutely.
You know,
that's true. When a picture goes up on Facebook, let's say I put your picture up on Facebook, that picture is now in the public domain. Isn't that right?
Yep. Pretty
isn't
much.
That right, Francis? It's in the public domain. It belongs to everybody.
Can screenshot it.
You can screenshot it.
Yeah. They can.
And can you use it in an advertisement? One of your pictures in an advertisement?
Legally, absolutely not. But illegally, it can be done. If it can be done, it will be done. And your wedding photographs could end up on an advertisement. They could end up with your head removed and somebody else's head put on top of it.
That's right.
It could end up you know, in a place we don't want to go or think about. But just be careful. Be careful.
Because it does go into the public domain, doesn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah.
How about you, Eleanor? Have you ever had pictures, you know, not robbed, but you know.
Robbed, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
And used
yeah.
for...
Taken.
Yeah.
And taken.
Yes.
Really?
I think that's what we have to call it. Yeah. It is basically, it's stealing. It's
you see, yeah. I suppose coming from our point of view as well, we need to put photographs out there.
Yeah.
Because we're such a visual medium. We need to show people our
Absolutely.
Work.
Absolutely.
So, yes, I do. I put up, if I can and I get permission, I'll put photographs up, but I would put my watermark on them.
Yeah.
But yeah, my photographs, they were taken.
Really?
Now, a long time ago, they were, and the watermark just taken out of it.
Oh.
Yeah. So.
Which means, you see, it's scary because people can argue that you can use that as a as for advertising, whatever.
Absolutely, yeah.
Which isn't really cool.
No, but I suppose if you went down, I don't even want to go near the legal route of it, but
the
you can prove you've had that image and where the image is coming from,
yes,
or you would
right.
have a catalogue of images to go with it.
Yeah. I suppose just a case of people really being aware that when your image is on Facebook, it's not to worry about.
Yeah. No, exactly.
Oh,
but
exactly,
it kind of is in the public
about.
Domain, you know.
Yeah.
So.
Very good.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Well, I think we're going well. Just a few more comments from online. Brian, do you want to take them or will I take them?
Yeah, I've got one.
Okay.
Up here, somebody wondering on Snapchat, do they get the negatives after, or the pictures on
a
CD?
The images.
Or is that extra?
Do they get negatives? Okay, well,
or the
just,
images on a
just
CD.
Just to explain to people, we say generally when people are talking about negatives, they're talking about the raw images, and it's one of these topics
the
that
images.
We were kind of going. Basically, to explain
images.
People, we say the raw images is like your ingredients for a cake. You know, it's like providing people with eggs and expecting a cake. You know, it's something that. You know, when we take the photographs, we spend hours afterwards editing those, getting them to a precise color, to correct exposure, everything, right? And by handing you back the raws is like, you know, it's like handing you the ingredients and telling you, right, go and make the cake. You'll never, a lot of people
well,
are
most,
not going to be able
most
to
computers won't open a raw file.
No, exactly.
Of
the size
they're
of them
huge
alone.
As well. Like
yeah,
the average,
absolutely.
I know our cameras would say, I'm shooting on 5D4, it's about 30 megs now. So they're 30 meg files,
for
and on
starters.
Average we're providing 300 to 500 images. So even from the capacity side, it's very hard for us to supply it. But I think
I don't think anybody really expects the raw file. I.e.,
no.
when you say the raw file, this is the file that comes out of the camera.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone expects that. But I think people nowadays do hope to get the USB sort of or sort of like
the digital
images.
The digital images,
and
it
gives a responsibility also to them to archive them properly.
Absolutely.
Not just me, you're not just the photographer.
Yeah. I think it's actually one of the things we do stress to a lot of our brides and couples is that, you know, when we're handing you this USB,
good luck.
Your responsibility.
Absolutely.
You need
you
to
go.
Back this up.
You
need to
copy that.
This is you know, this is all
That's
your
right.
images. You
there
need
you go.
To make sure they're backed up.
Yeah.
So it's one of these things that, you know, it's the responsibility of the couple to take care of those USBs and take care of the images.
Yeah.
I suppose, speaking of which, we say regarding. We say things that people do by mistake, but wedding photography mistakes is one thing I wanted to touch on and kind of how to avoid them. So, like, with all the experience in the room here, we have umpteen amount of weddings.
Sorry,
like,
Richard, just before you go to that, just clear that up, because a few people have come in on Snapchat.
Oh, okay.
So, just with the same question, do they get their images on a CD after?
Okay.
I think that was the not raw images, but actually
I edited out images.
Yeah.
Let's go, Francis.
Yeah.
Francis.
No, I feel that the question was when they used the term negative, they actually meant a digital file of that image.
That was just one of them said negative.
Okay.
And
my mistake. Sorry.
I can speak for us all here that we have that option that they can purchase a license. To use printable JPEGs for their own personal use. And their personal use is for themselves and their friends and family. It's not for third party, like for advertising and selling to stock images for billboards and that.
Yeah.
That
yeah.
comes into a completely different category there.
Yeah.
But most photographers nowadays, professional photographers, will give that option that they can purchase a license to use, and that's what we give you as a license there.
Yeah,
and
image,
the image, something you mentioned earlier on, that we create, we would add the love to that image to make it a really nice pleasing to the eye, artistic, the way we crop it, the way we...
Our secret sauce.
Yeah. Absolutely. It comes from, that's where we get creative and artistic. If the printing end we can't control.
Yeah.
Some printing labs will have an auto preset that will make an analysis, we're going to make this photograph better. Mm. But if that photograph comes from a professional photographer, by them putting that preset, it's actually going to kill the image. Yeah. It's going to just undo all the good work there. So just be careful. I give people that information now that they ask wherever they're getting it printed to take off the presets, the auto presets on it. Mm. And once they lift that off, then it should be printed close enough to how we want it to be.
Yes. But, well, of course,
like when we're sending images to different album companies, we will match their colour profiles.
Yes. Exactly, yeah.
And each album company, each lab have different machines, mm-hmm. and they all have different colour profiles.
Yeah.
So we try to match them for the best possible quality for your images. Absolutely.
And I think it's something we were saying regarding, we say most photographers supply digital images. We say if they have a digital package, that's generally what they're talking about, in that it's supplying digital images. So I think it's something you need to discuss with your wedding photographer.
Absolutely.
And find out, are you getting, you know, is the digital images included? Is it something that, you know, that they need to look at and stuff like that? So it's one of those things, again, back to the scenario where talk to your wedding photographer and find out, again, when you're booking your wedding photographer, talk to your wedding photographer and find out what is included.
Absolutely.
Are the digital images included? Yeah. So I think we'll say it's something that, it's a very tricky subject, because when people talk about digital negatives, we automatically think RAW.
Yes.
You know? Yeah. So it's maybe use the right phrasing as well. It's the digital images, high resolution images.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many different names for it. But basically images that you can literally print yourself.
Yeah.
That's the main idea, you know? We've covered a lot tonight. Now, I think we're nearly an hour at this now. So I'm going to give literally just a few more comments that you just saw popping up there.
That wasn't too bad, was it?
That wasn't too bad, was it?
I saw one comment up there.
Elshigam saying about no phones, tablets, etc. Most couples asking for it now, and also not to put pics up on media. Christina Tuffy, we just got our wedding album from Eleanor last week, and couldn't be happier. Eleanor is such a perfectionist. Amazing.
Thank you, Christina.
Very good. Thanks, Brian. Actually, he said I'm also one of the best, so that's great. Thanks, Brian, for that. Sinead, actually, one thing actually I did with Sinead Conlon, one of my brides, and she just posted in there, we post our own first pics instead of Richard putting sneak peek up. So it's an option I give to every couple listen, and again, I presume we all do it, but literally that if we can send you the photographs and you post them up, you know, so then you have the control. Like the whole thing about, we'll say, digital images is who's in control.
Yes.
Who want, you know, so if you want your wedding photographer to send you the photographs, I don't think that's going to be a major issue with any photographer, you know. Mm-hmm. And they can kind of make sure that they are the proper colour and they're done with style, you know, with a bit of heart and secret sauce. I suppose one of the final questions I did see, the video guys, that's obviously Mick Summer. What is your favourite photo to take? Which is a nice little teaser there. Steve, we'll start with you. What is your favourite photograph to take at a wedding? Do you want to come back to you?
I'd like to be honest with the picture, with the answer. So I have to think about it.
Okay, cool.
I'll tell you.
We'll go ladies up. First, will we?
Yeah, well, okay. Yeah,
yeah, we'll go ladies first. Well, okay.
Yeah,
Eleanor, what is your favourite pick of the day? This is putting you in the spot, because
absolutely,
we
haven't talked. No. I think my favourite shot is when I'm at the top of the church. The bride is walking up when there are no cameras blocking her view, but I actually pan to him. I zoom over to the groom and I get his picture.
Absolutely.
He's not looking at her, or he mightn't have seen her yet, but he's going.
You stole my favourite pick.
Did I?
No, I appreciate this. He's stuck for words.
Yeah. Very good.
Yeah. My own experience, when I walked up the aisle, to the top of the aisle, and my husband Sean never spoke to me. I says, oh my God. And he says, He couldn't. He lost the words. Yeah. First time, trust me, in his life, he was stuck for words. And it's so emotional. Guys, shower, shave, hop into the suits, yeah. Bob's your uncle. Then all of a sudden, the music starts.
And it hits.
The people stand.
Yeah.
And yeah. a rush of emotions. Yeah. And yeah. it's priceless. Yeah. Mm. Absolutely. Yeah. And the brides love that shot.
Oh, exactly.
They
exactly.
really, really
absolutely.
Do.
Absolutely. Yeah. But you can't say that one for better yeah. now, so you need to say no. one.
Oh, I have so many. But to me, with every couple, there's that special image. Mm. And it may never be replicated again. Special, special image. Here's one special image here. The special image is the priest. I don't know if you can see that, guys.
Well, show this camera to get closer. Yeah. I think that one's better.
Sorry, he's brilliant. Looking for that's help. another special image just even here. Really important, and I left it to the last. This is where the groom proposed.
Oh, lovely. Ah. Yeah. That is, so that's, I know that shot as well. That is down near Ashford Castle, isn't it? In Cong?
That's Cong, yes.
Yes, yeah, a beautiful place.
You know, we had to go there. We had yeah. to go to that spot, absolutely. And it was magic, it happened. Yeah. So with every couple, there is something that just is extra special to them. And that's what we do. We just yeah. try and get in there.
Yeah. Exactly. I think that's one thing, like Steve would say, I have to kind of apologize as well. Steve was one of my mentors. So like I learned everything from Steve. So he's the master. But the one thing that Stevie specialized in is pure emotion, like that natural image, you know, and you have yeah. this knack of getting... You know, a shot of, you know, like that, we'll say the groom, we'll say as the bride's coming up the altar. And, you know, it just, I think that's one of the things we do. We capture that emotion. We capture that kind of reaction, you know.
To me, my favorite picture would have to be when the bride and groom have a laugh with each other.
Yeah. Mm.
And don't bother smiling for the camera because I'm not here. If let the two of them somehow create the space so they can laugh with each other. Is that's a key shot.
Their yeah. moments,
that's moments. That's the
yes.
moment.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
And they laugh at and with each other.
Yeah.
That's,
I love that. I would do that all day long.
Yeah. No, it's a good one. And I like yeah. they've all robbed my favourite photos of the day.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah, we should ask you. Hey, Richard.
And I should have actually been thinking about this while I was asking that, Nola.
What's your favourite picture today?
I don't have one particular favourite. I love getting a photograph of... I love the shot of the bride when the father of the bride sees her that morning, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. and it's that look on his face and he's finally realising, this is my daughter getting married, you know. Mm-hmm. It's that real emotional thing. And, you know, it's something that if I see, you know, when the bride sees her photographs and she sees that photograph and a tear wells up her eye, I know I've done my job. You know, if I get the tears, I've done my job. And it's just that, like, that emotion that you're seeing is one of my favorites. I have to say, it's one of my favorites.
Or the mum.
Exactly. Yeah. I love that.
We should actually have pictures.
I think we might try and do it in post-prime. We kind of get some of the photos that we're talking about.
These are just gorgeous.
But it's literally getting that emotion, I think, is the key, we'll say. And you know, it's one of the things I always say to people when you are looking at your photographer, look at their images. Look at what they've done in the past. Mm. You know, and a lot of photographers will tell you what happened when that shot happened, you know. Yeah. And it's one of these things that, you know, we remember what happened to that moment, you know?
And it'll take them back there. They will, by that image is so powerful, it'll take them back there.
Absolutely.
It will bring all those, when the flowers are all gone, yes.
Yeah.
It'll bring those emotions back to that stage.
Yeah.
And their journey.
Mm. Yeah, there's journey. One little comment that came in there from Julie Kikoli. Do you ever try and get that sneaky shot when they think no one is watching and they finally relax? I think that's pretty much all our shots we try and do. Is try and get that relaxed shot, you know. How are we in time, Brian? We doing okay?
Yeah, you're okay.
Okay, I think we kind of have covered quite a lot tonight, so I think we'll wrap it up with that. I think we've been on for about an hour now.
Thanks for watching, everybody.
So basically, that's it for another episode. Thank you to our guests, Steve Rogers. Thank you very much. Francis Muldoon and Eleanor Corcoran. Make sure to check out their websites after you visit richardmccarthy.ie. I'm only joking.
richardmccarthy.ie.
Actually, can you give us our website? Sorry, can you give us, how do people contact you? Steve, we'll say, how do people contact Steve Rogers?
steverogersphoto.com.
Fantastic.
Now, there's a bunch of Steve Rogers photographers. There's a dude out in Newfoundland. Howdy to the man in Newfoundland. There's another dude out in Canada. Hello to the man in Canada. Steve Rogers out in Canada. But
so the Irish Steve Rogers is...
Irish Steve Rogers. Steve Rogers photography, Sligo or whatever that
was. Fantastic. Francis, how do people contact Francis Muldoon?
FrancisMuldoon.ie. Just look up my website and or pop out to me in the studio in Ross's Point.
Ross's Point. And Eleanor, your go is Eleanor Corcoran, but you're Eleanor C. Eleanor we all know C. you as Eleanor C.
Yes.
So how do people contact Eleanor C Photography?
Yes, they can check out my website, Eleanor C Photography. I'm on Facebook.
Very good. Is Eleanor C Photography.ie.com?
Sorry,
.ie.
.ie, perfect. Yeah, and I'm on Facebook, Eleanor C Photography. I'm also on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat.
So many things to be honest.
Eleanor C Photo, yeah, too definitely. Or just Google platforms. Me.
Exactly. I think that's the easiest thing. Is Google. I think there's only one Eleanor Corcoran, there's only one Francis Muldoon, there's three Steve Rogers, but look for the Irish one.
Four,
you know, yeah. You now know what he looks like and everything as well, so there we go.
Captain Steve America. Wonder.
Can we give one tip to the brides and grooms out there?
Yeah, cool.
Yep.
Okay, well, seeing as you suggested, we're gonna go with your tip first.
Okay. Really important. The main reason why brides are late is there's been a domino effect that morning. Mm-hmm. Okay? Start early with your preparations, your hair, your makeup. Please don't leave yourselves last. You are number one. The number one reason why everyone is there, even for your fiancé, he's going to be there because you're number one. Put yourself number one to get your hair done and the makeup done. Because if you're left to last and it takes a little longer to get the hair done here or the makeup then, it'll have a domino effect. Yeah. You'll be pacing. You don't want to be photographed without the makeup on. And then that's a rush, panic, and
photographer doesn't
stress.
Really
you
want
don't
to get
want
in close.
That.
I know.
You just don't want that. It's your day. Enjoy, 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 enjoy. Great. Fantastic. Lovely.
Eleanor, what's your
tip
of the day?
Yeah, definitely, you know, start the morning and maybe brides try to be ready an hour before you're actually to be ready.
That
you know,
the
because
that is it.
So that they can relax. But you know what I always tell my couples and I try to tell them is like that, is to stop during the day, a couple of times during the day, take a deep breath in and to take it in because it goes so quick.
True.
I'll always say to them to stop. I usually stop my bride in the morning, or I'll stop her before she walks up the aisle, and I'll tell her to take a moment because it gets me a chance to get to the top of the aisle.
Yeah, exactly.
And then when the couple get together, when they meet, or when we go to our location, I'll let them have a few minutes to themselves. It's just to take it in because it goes so quick.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
good
to enjoy it.
Good point.
Steve, fill us with your wisdom. What's your top tip?
Top tip. Same thing. Yeah. Has to be the same thing as what Francis just said there and on there. Look, timing at the beginning of the day sets the tone for the rest of it.
Yeah.
Be ready ahead of time. For heaven's sake, don't leave it. It takes 45 minutes sometimes to get to the church. Even if it's a 5-minute journey.
Work out the travel times beforehand, all that
working
kind of
all
thing.
That out is such
time
a time,
out.
Such a lifesaver,
and
great fun. Actually, the whole thing is fun.
And we can help you at the time, but from our experience, we know how normally the length of time it takes to go from A to B.
Mm.
How long, if you're having a church wedding, you're going to be 2 hours there.
Yeah.
That's from our experience.
Yeah.
Talk to us. We'll help you in every possible way.
Mm. And Richard, what's your top tip? I suppose we should.
One tip actually I think is very important is, you know, if you are nervous, if you're not that confident when it comes to photography and the whole lot, really do, you know, talk to your photographer about an engagement shoot. Like it is basically a practice session. It will make you feel more relaxed. It will make you feel more confident on the day and the whole lot.
Because it's just the two of you with
it's
the photographer.
Exactly.
It's easy.
It's a half hour on a Saturday or a Sunday or a week or something. And it's a bit of crack. And you get some lovely photographs of it. So that not all your photographs are all going to be, you know, of your wedding day. You'll have photographs before your wedding day.
Yeah, you want a picture of you and your dog. You know, if you've got a dog.
Bring the dog. Bring the squirrel if you want. Anybody you want. You know, it's no problem at all.
And something we mentioned earlier on, we were talking beforehand, is, you know, if photography is important to you, please, if somebody offers to take your wedding photographs free of charge, I've got a new camera here and I'd love...
Uncle Tom.
Please don't go down that road. Yeah. I've had 9 couples in my studio with a disc asking me, is there anything I can do with them? Yeah. And, yeah. you know, the truth is we can't.
Yeah.
We can try and do something again, but just be careful. And there are cowboys out there as well. Yeah. Just
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. I think, remember, you only get to do it once. Most people will only get to do it once. So, you know, you really do need to capture the day properly, you know. So invest in the professionals. That's definitely all I can say. Okay, so basically, thanks all for visiting. Thanks all for watching the show. Thanks as always to our lovely guests tonight. Thank you very much. I think a round of applause is in order. We'll put that in afterwards in the feed. Thanks as always to Brian for producing the show and Michael, and to you at home for joining us. We'll be monitoring the social media feeds for another half hour or so. So if you have anything you want to continue the conversation or you want to message us privately, we'll be here to respond. If you're watching this on YouTube or on repeat on Facebook and you'd like to get in touch, then leave your comments in the comment section below. Drop us an email, send us a text, contact us, whatever way you want, whatever you feel like doing, or call into the store here in Clooney. If you're a wedding service provider and would like to get involved in the discussion, simply get in touch and we'll try to schedule a date for you to join us. We'd love to have you on. If you have news and you would like to share it with couples or suppliers, again, get in touch. Thanks again for watching. If you've missed earlier shows, they're all online on our YouTube channel. Just search My Wedding Store. We're on episode 8 now, I think. So there's 7 lovely episodes to watch to keep you entertained. There's a playlist set up where you want to watch all the episodes back to back if you want. Or you can click here. We hopefully will have some links here in the post to get to previous episodes. The best way of keeping in tune with the show and keeping in touch with the show is to subscribe. So please subscribe and you'll be notified each time an episode or other relevant wedding related clips are uploaded. We hope you enjoyed the show and found it beneficial. Again, feedback welcomed. Just be gentle. Until same time next week, Wednesdays, 8 p.m. Good night from all of us.
Good night.
Thank you.
Thanks for listening. Bye.